The class is a silent killer because, like, it, obviously it's invisible, you know, you can't see it, you can't smell it. In my case, the carbon monoxide come from next door's house, so, you know what I mean, it is literally the silent killer.
But otherwise, what, gas-fired boilers, cookers?
Yeah, even charcoal. We had a lot of deaths last year due to people taking barbecues into the tents whilst camping, and you know what I mean, and that's like a no-no, you know what I mean? It comes from all fossil fuels, you know what I mean, like I say, even charcoal. Yeah.
And presumably, before what happened to Dominic, you, like many other people, had no idea
God,
could be dangerous.
Yeah. Even the day Dominic died, when the coroner said it was carbon monoxide, I had to ask my family what it was because I'd never heard of it before.
To get a... I mean, lots of people have smoke alarms. I mean, pretty much everybody has a smoke alarm these days, don't they? But carbon monoxide alarms, people don't think about it, and they're just very simple devices, aren't they?
Well, that's it. I mean, people are seeing like a smoke alarm and thinking that it's combined with a carbon monoxide alarm, but they are like separate. I mean, you can get like joint ones, but to have one of those, you know what I mean, that can save your family.
And they don't, how much do they cost to install them and to buy them as well? Do you know, Stacey?
Well, to buy them, you can talk about £12 up to £20, £30, depending on like the strength of the parts per million, but. Yeah, I think every home should definitely have one of those.
And they're very easy to install. You've got these slots on the back, you just hook them on.
Well, that's that. I mean, you could even put it on your mantelpiece, so it's not even the matter of installing it, you know what I mean? And, like, if you're going on holiday, like, you can take it on holiday with you as well, so...
So you can even take it on holiday. Now, that's a very good idea. I'd not thought of that. So those people who are going in tents, as you're saying, with the carbon monoxide poisoning, take it camping with you?
Yeah, take it camping with you. Take it everywhere. Yeah. I mean, even like me staying in the hotel last night.
You had it with you?
Brought mine with me, yeah.
Really?
Yeah,
gosh.
It travels everywhere with me. Yeah.
Smoke alarms go on the ceiling, of course. Where is the best place to put these?
Well, I think it goes down to a manufacturer's instructions, but, you know what I mean, it's like me, I've got about 5 in my home because I'm totally, you know, totally paranoid.
Yeah, that's the thing, though. People will think, well, do you need one in every room, in which case that's, you're talking about, you know, 4, 5, 6 alarms, and then you're getting on towards 100 quid then, aren't you?
I think even if you've got one in, you know what I mean, if I'd have had one in my house, then maybe Dominic would have been here today. So, you know, so even if you've got one, then, you know, that's fine.
And you just went to wake him up one morning and he died in his bed, did he? Or?
Yeah, what I thought was just like a normal school day. You know what I mean? Normally he'd come like waltzing out of his bedroom, and that morning he never come waltzing out. And, you know, I went through every parent's worst nightmare that morning. And
of course you did.
You know, so I started the campaign. So if I save one life, then I'm happy and I'll carry on.